Welcome back, and you're still on Urban Television. The show is called Urban Today for those of you who are just joining us. Without much further ado, let's get straight into the everyday hassles that people go through right here in Kampala. Check out Mona Kampala.
I'm Sinabuli Awaswanua. I'm a printing machine operator. Call me a technician or a printer. I've been a technician for 5 years, but I've spent 3 years with New Vision. Working with Univision, I joined in 2013 up to now. Challenges most especially come with the materials we use. For example, papers. Some papers crease, and when they crease, the machine does not register. So some pictures come when they are not so clear. And the most of all, since we are running the machine on a very high speed and at a high tension, when power gets off, it will all break down because we are using a paper. A web is just running through the machine to the folder, they'll all break. We shall have wrap around, so it will take us some good hours to sort that. Since I started Vision, first of all, I wanted to work for a company that is well established. Obviously, that is building my CV in one way or the other. And since I'm in a well-established company, benefits are much, and I'm looking forward to doing some other things apart from Vision. I'll have to go study hard, and my CV is building. I'm exposed. That's why you also got me here, and I'm on your camera. I've seen a number of people, big people, and most of all, I've got the best machine in East Africa. Here, we are running the best machine. I don't think there are so many in Africa. It is fully automatic. So I'm exercising all what I studied in school here, which I would not have got. I've worked for some other companies, but they do not have some good machine like this one. So I'm exposed and I've enlightened more about my skills. Other benefit is sustaining myself. I have a family. I came here, I did not have a child. I'm having a very, very, very beautiful baby girl. I'm taking care of my family, my other family, extended family, not the people I stay with at home. I'm looking forward to going to university. I've collected some money still from here. I'm going for an advanced learning in electrical engineering. And I'm taking care of people in the village. I'm starting different projects in agriculture still from Vision. So I less to talk, but a lot have been done. I've done really a lot in joining Vision. There is a big challenge with people who have not gone to school. I know when you're not going to school, it's not the end of the world. You can really do a lot. But if there is chance, please do. Even though people are saying that we are educated and employed, but there is that slightest chance you have enough. When I finished school in 2013, I tried some other companies, I worked, I went and repaired some phones somewhere, and I decided to go to the village. So from the village, people thought I had failed in my education, but at the back of my mind, I knew what I wanted. So that's why I applied for this job, and Vision saw from my papers, saw some potential in me, and I'm here now. So if I did not have that bit of education, I would not be here. But still, there is this adult learning. People can advance faster. They can advance and cope up. People should start businesses. I'm learned, I'm working, but I'm so much in agriculture and the village. By the way, there is a lot of money that side. So people who are not educated, I'm telling my brothers, the youths, please try something that will bring you income. At least 10,000 a day or 5,000 is enough to run year around. I can advise them that. At least let them go do farming, start with these small jobs. At least if you have a small job that's giving you 30,000 and you are doing three of them a day, you're having 9,000. At least that's a good start.
Welcome back, and that was Mona Kampala right there. I remember earlier on I told you I'll be talking to another beautiful guest we have here in the studio, and this time round we're talking about health. And we do have the Vision Group Health Camp, or Vision Group is participating in a health camp. We had an interview last week talking about the same thing, health camp. And just to remind you again how important your health, my health, our health as a whole country is. It is very important. With that said, I do have a guest called Ruth Ayal in our studios. How are you doing?
I'm okay. How are you?
Not bad. You know, the first time you said your name, I was like, Ruth Ayal. I'm like, interesting name. I've never heard
very
that.
Very Ugandan.
It's actually a really nice name.
Yeah.
Now, could you please introduce yourself to some of our viewers?
Okay. Good morning, viewers. I want to take this opportunity to thank Vision Group for this opportunity to take part in this year's medical health camp. I'm Ruth Ayal. I'm from Ian Hatchon Clinic for Children. It's a UK-based charity working within Uganda. Currently, we're working in partnership with KCCA.
Mm.
We are in Kisugu and Kiseni.
Right.
Our main work is pushing for early detection and prevention of hearing loss among children.
Oh.
Yes.
By the time you're saying our focus is on hearing detection, early hearing detection or problems with hearing, is it because it's become a big issue in Uganda per se? Or it's just a decision you made as a company, let's focus on this?
I think it's an area that has not been touched so much within the charity sector and all that. It's a growing need. We're seeing many children coming in with challenges of hearing loss.
Mm.
And we've seen the past few months, we're seeing our numbers at the clinic growing every other day. So we know there's a need for this. And we're pushing for early detection because if hearing loss is gotten at an early stage, then the child may be able to have better results.
Yes.
But we want to be able to close the gap of many of our children are coming in at 2.5 years, 3 years, which is a little late for them to really benefit from the
medication.
So early detection, yes. We're thinking newborn screening.
Mm-hmm.
If children can be screened after birth at 6 weeks, early detection, we're thinking within the first 6 months. And currently, we've just started a project at Kiseni, and we're doing newborn screening. Mothers are getting to understand how important it is to have a hearing test for your baby done as early as possible.
How is that done? Because I'm the first one, so I do remember seeing my baby sister coming home. I don't think there was a hearing test done for
her. Yes.
So in case we missed, before we, actually let's begin with first, in case we've already missed the first at birth, the hearing detection, in case we've missed that, I'm imagining there's a mother out there now who's concerned, watching, and they're like, wait, my kid is 7. I'm not sure if they even hear me. How do you
For us, the mother is the first person or frontline person that will detect that a child is not hearing.
Mm.
And we are telling mothers as early as possible, is within the first 6 months. So if they come in and have a hearing test done and the child needs help, then if we start that early, they can have better results.
Yes.
Better results. So the screening we're doing, we have machines that test the hearing of a child. And it's a very simple test. It takes about 10 minutes if a child cooperates and they're out. So we're having mothers coming. We're doing it on Monday and Wednesday morning. When they come in for immunization, we ask them to also pass by and have the hearing test done for their children. And you can see the smile on their faces when they see pass.
Yes.
Then also the concern on their faces when they tell them, I think your baby has not passed. And we do a follow-up for them to come back after a period of time and we repeat the test.
Yes.
Some still, after failing the first time, they pass the second time.
Yes.
Others will still fail. So we need to follow up on those and provide as much help as possible.
What if I am home? Mm. I'm home. Like, are there signs when you still have your child?
Mm.
Yes, you've gone through immunization, but really hearing tests is not something that most of us have heard about.
Yes,
I'm just hearing about this because when I was growing up, there was nothing like that.
I was never tested also.
So I'm assuming my mom was like, wait, you done, wait, or something. So are there signs
a
mother should watch out for?
Yes, the simple basic things a mother would look out for. Usually a baby would, maybe if you bang the door when they're sleeping, they would respond.
Mm.
And at different stages as they grow up, the different milestones, they should be able to respond to sound. And either door bang or starting to say baby words, those little simple things. So for some mothers who come in the clinic, they say, I noticed my child wasn't doing things, but I thought they will catch up. They would catch up.
Yeah, because we have that.
Yes, that mentality.
We have that mentality like, no, they're just slow, especially is it between boys and girls?
Yeah.
Like, no, these ones, girls grow faster than boys.
Yes.
There's that whole notion.
So we're asking them, come and make sure we just rule out the fact that the child's hearing is fine. if it is done and the child is fine, then we begin to refer them to look at other health providers and see what other factors are affecting the child. Why is the child talking at their normal age?
Okay,
why is the child?
Okay.
Yes, so that's a core of what we do. We deal with children from 0 to 16 years.
Okay.
Yes.
Wow, 0 to 16. That's a huge.
That's a huge group.
We're really hoping
we can have many more coming in as early as possible. That is why we are really having keen interest in taking part in this health camp.
Yes.
And we hope we'll have mothers coming in to have their children tested and have their hearing screening done. Maybe there are many others out there that mothers are concerned about the child's hearing. My child's not hearing, he's making twos. So come in, let them have their hearing test done. We will have an audiologist that will be doing the screening and hearing tests. And they can be able to talk to her and consult about hearing.
About
hearing
and a few other things. And first of all, you've even introduced a new word, audiologist. I didn't even know we had something like that.
Oh, there are very few in the country. I kept laughing with my colleague, and she said there are just 3 in their class.
There are only 3?
3 in their class.
In this population of ours, there's a how many newborns are born every single day?
Oh, my.
So what exactly does the audiologist do?
She's the person that particularly does the hearing testing.
Is there some talking? Because I'm very interested in knowing exactly what happens.
For some tests, we can be able to do them in a normal environment, the screening.
Okay,
but the other
okay.
tests that have to be done in a sound treated room, so the tests can be done. And depending on the age of the child, it will determine which kind of test.
But now, how
can
available?
Be done for them.
How available is this, especially right here in Uganda? We're giving birth all over the country. I'm seeing somebody in Gulu, somebody watching from Barara.
It's a very, I know it's
available.
A very big dream. I don't know when we'll get there, but we hope. That's why particularly working with in partnership with KCCA or a government-based hospital. We hope in the near future some of these systems can be absorbed.
Yes.
And maybe a mother can access these different services. Wherever it is. Currently, we are just in Kiseni, and I think after a few years, maybe government will pick interest in this and say, this is actually a need.
Yes.
And then maybe roll it out to different other centers.
Other centers.
Yes.
That would be really beautiful. Now, coming back to IHCC, I can't pronounce it, but that statement was, how do you say it?
Ian Hatchon Clinic for Children, IHCC.
This is when mother tongue influence embarrasses you, Ian. What more does a IHCC offer when it comes to especially children?
Okay. On the side of detection, we are doing hearing tests and screening. Then we're also doing prevention, and we run an ear disease clinic. There we treat the common ear diseases.
And
that's the sign of prevention. If we can treat those diseases, then we can be able to prevent hearing loss. If people can access good medical health and have the disease managed properly, then hearing loss can be prevented. We have a child that have had a past discharge for a very long period of time, and if they have it for a very
from
long period
ear.
Of time,
yes,
then it will, in the long run, affect their hearing. The hearing will start going down.
You know, this is very scary information. You've just made me realize how sensitive the ear itself
the
is.
The ear itself. I think I never used to think so much about hearing until I started working particularly with IHCC. I don't take it anymore for granted, but I have 2 ears that hear well.
Yes, they hear very well.
That I have a little son that hears well. Those little things, until you begin to see children come in and the mother is saying, please do the test again. I just want to know that my child hears. And you're saying, I'm sorry, your child did not pass the test.
Yes.
Those are things we take for granted that you have no more hearing.
So I'm just... Because right now, you've actually really scared me. I'm just thinking
please
of so many
not.
Things. Yes.
You hear
I'm
very well.
Yeah, I'm now very worried. Because if it's something that has become, by the time IHCC has decided to focus on this, then that means there is actually a problem.
Mm.
There is lack of knowledge.
Yes.
So what I'm hearing is an ear infection, be it just something small, could actually cause
not managed well,
a bigger problem
a chronic
if it's not
one.
Treated.
Treated over a long period of time and not managed well, that child's hearing may be affected. Be having a teenage boy about 14, 15 years, he's had that kind of condition for a very long period of time and his hearing has actually gone so down. So he's had to be aided. He's getting a hearing aid to help him be able to pull those sounds that he's not been able to hear. But as we talked to the parent, our emphasis was, yes, we're giving your child a hearing aid, but the biggest part is to make sure that his ears are as healthy as possible, that you make sure that the infection is not coming in and you're not managing it well.
Yes.
Yes, so that's the kind of awareness we really want to create within the health camp.
When we say ear infection, I mean, even as grown-ups, we do get these ear infections, but we never really take it seriously. You just walk into a pharmacy, and like I'm just, I feel like, or you know, we use our earbuds and really.
Yes.
Now it comes to babies. I do know babies' ears have to be cleaned. Are we doing it the right way to avoid certain infections? Because even as grown-ups, sometimes there's that, you know that, for you even feel it over here, that's the itch, you feel it down here. So you want to put the cotton bud straight in.
Others who come in and saying, I can't hear well, And for babies, we're as much as just working around the clinic, I've been able to understand as much as possible, we're not encouraging people to use earbuds to clean their ears. Mm. If you can use just tissue and clean, just simply, because the ear itself has own mechanisms for making sure that it is
clean. But sometimes you feel like you have to remove the ear wax.
And in the process of doing that, you damage your ear. Then they come back and say, I think I have pain in my ear. When you check in and ask him, what for you exactly? I use the stick. And some of them I use really go all the way.
Especially in the villages, because I don't think people do have time to start buying cotton buds. These are just things in the city. And even me, sometimes the cotton bud is not working well, so I need to pick something effective. Like, because that itch is so sweet, and we might end up actually injuring ourselves. Talking about also the ear, because now I'm really interested in this ear thing. How do we encourage people to take care of the ears? And when I mean people, I don't mean people in the city centers, near Kampala or Mbarara City. No, because those ones at least are a little bit knowledgeable. Now, on the outskirts, how do we get people to take care of the ear? Because it is something very important.
Yes, very important. I might as well also ask them to, if you can seek help, if you have a condition in the ear, seek at least professional help. Some people just run closest to the clinic and the
because
person doesn't know anything
know.
Else to say and
we
just
don't
say
know what it is. Just look at me now scratching my ear. I'm ready. Because we don't know.
Pick
it's
that
true.
That eardrop and use it, and they're using gentamicin, you know, what some of the things that are not very good. But the basic few things of keeping your ears clean, making sure you avoid dirty water from getting in. If for children, if they get flu or cough, as much as possible, let the mother make sure they treat the cough and treat the flu, so that it can cure. Because many of them sometimes have a half influenza cough for a long period of time, then the ears, are the next thing to be affected. So treat the cough and treat the flu.
This flu,
for them, they're still
very vulnerable.
Still delicate.
Yes.
So those few things, just maintenance, hygiene, clean their ears. If a mother has a concern, seek professional help as much as possible, especially for the ears.
Okay.
If they can get.
Now, let's get back into the health camp that will be happening very soon. Could you please give us a little bit more details? Where do we come? How do we participate? Do we need money?
No.
What is the procedure if we want more help? Or if we have questions pertaining to ear health, if I may call it, how do we go ahead from here? Even way after the camp is done.
We're very excited about taking part in the Vision Health Camp. The camp will be taking place at the railway ground. We will also camp there, pitch our tent. And for the health, within the health camp, we'll be treating common ear diseases. As many people you have, please come in and you'll be able to see somewhere to treat you and give you medication, free medication. Then also the audiologist will also be around to do the hearing tests and screening and talk to as many people that have a concern about their children's hearing and all that. She will be available to speak to you, to counsel, to guide. And then the screenings that we do within the health camp, there are some tests that we may not be able to do. Yes, at the rally ground. So if a child fails a test or needs follow-up, we're going to pick up on them and ask that they come through to the clinic in Kiseni and then we can do the rest of the tests and see how we can they can benefit. So those who pass, we discharge them. Those that need to continue with us, we will follow up on them at the clinic in Kisenyi.
And how about in situations where clearly the damage could actually be way more than anticipated? What is the procedure forward? Because you said you deal with kids from 0 to about 16.
If a child comes in and their hearing is really, really down, after we've done the tests and yes, a child has failed, we do have to recommend them to go to deaf school. Yes, and we do counsel the parent and ask them to, as much as early as possible, get the child into deaf school and also give them hope that your world is not
I know
it's hard news to break out to a parent and tell them, okay, your child does not hear, but there is still hope. They can still be able to live a normal life, get a good education, but it requires a lot of social support from the family, from the parent, because the parent also needs to learn some sign language to communicate.
Exactly.
Yeah, to communicate with
the parent.
The child
has to be taught
Yes. And usually, either it's in Tinder, wherever it is, they do have those kind of classes for the parents and then for the children, so that the child can feel they're living
a part of a family and part of actually living a normal life.
Yes.
Talking about that, because I've seen growing up when I was still in Nairobi, there was a child, and to be honest, we also didn't know what the problem is.
Yes.
I cannot blame myself. I was a child too.
Yeah.
I don't know what the problem was. Mm. But yes, communication was so hard.
Yes.
She was called Vivian, and we didn't know she was deaf, and the parents
would
get so, because she'd make sounds.
Yes.
She'd make sounds. I don't know what happened, but she could say hi, but it does not come out the way I would say hi.
Yes.
It comes out totally different.
Yes.
So the parents would beat that child a lot, thinking she's
just
being stubborn.
Yes, we've had some of those cases thinking
they are
children.
How do we get away, like, how do we get our the parents, especially, to get away from that? Because some will say, no, it's a witch doctor. I knew it.
Very, very true. Many of our, I think, still in Africa, we still have that kind of mentality. We have mentioned that parents that have come in and the child will complain. The child is stubborn. They don't listen to instructions. And
Vivian was stubborn. Oh, she used to beat us up. My God. But we didn't know until
some
later.
Some of them get violent, are very agitated, because they feel like no one is understanding. Oh, I'm trying to communicate and someone else is not communicating back to me. So after testing that and you tell the parent, actually your child does not have good hearing, then they begin to understand, okay, that's why I call her, she doesn't respond. That's why she's very agitated or angry
always
with
agitated.
The rest of us, of our siblings, because they feel like they're not communicating. So if you notice your child is having those kind of illness, please come in and then let the hearing test be done, and that is ruled out.
Yes.
If the hearing is fine, then they need to look at other factors.
Other factors.
Yes.
I must say thank you so much to you. Thank you so, so much.
Thank you for having me.
Because explains a lot about Vivian. But yes, after we found out that she was deaf, she went to school and she came back down.
Mm-hmm.
And she can talk.
Totally
but she
a different
just cannot
person.
Hear.
Yes.
But it just takes longer to understand exactly what she's trying to say. Mm. So thank you very much.
Thank
Do
you
remember
for
to
me.
Participate in the health camp.
Yes, we just
we shall
want
get
to
the
invite
railway.
The public to take part in it. Thank
yes.
you for having me.
Thank you so much for coming through. Hope to
You're
have
welcome.
You back again. With that said, remember, take care of your ears, even you as grown-ups right now. Take care of your ears. Even when you get that one from, you know that one? Be very careful. Be very careful. We'll be right back.
Okay.